Sober Girls Yoga. By the Mindful Life Practice.
Perfect. Okay, so let's start our practice in a seated shape. So we can come into a cross-legged shape. I'm just propped up on this cushion. You can close the eyes or soften the gaze. Let your head balance on both shoulders. Take deep breaths in and out and let your breath fill your lungs, fill your chest with air. Exhaling, emptying. Maybe just taking about 4 more deep breaths in and out. As you start to shift into stillness and silence, just do a little scan and develop some awareness around how you're feeling right now physically. How you're feeling mentally. And just decide what you want to get out of today's practice. Now let's just start to drop our right earlobe down towards our right shoulder. Maybe take the right palm, land it on the side of the skull, just stretch through the neck. Then we're going to lift our head all the way up and then drop our left earlobe down towards our left shoulder, land the palm on the side of the skull. Tip the head all the way up. We'll just do a few more shoulder openers while we're seated. So let's lift our arms open into cactus. And then just send the right arm underneath the left, and you can high five the hands or even grip opposite shoulders if you like. Maybe just taking one more round of breath. And then we're going to open our arms all the way up. And then go the opposite way so you can draw the left arm underneath the right and high five the hands or grip opposite shoulders. Let's take one more round of breath. Then we'll release the arms. Lift the right arm all the way up and let's see how it feels to just land the right palm on the left shoulder. Maybe weave the arm around, connect the palms together and just see how that feels. Just release the grip and we'll go the opposite way. just staying there for a couple more breaths. And then we'll just release the grip and slide off of, if you're on a cushion or anything. Come all the way onto the back, but let's use a block or a book if you have. And we're just going to press through the soles of the feet and lift the hips up and slide the block or the book underneath the sacrum. Stay here for three more breaths. And then press through both feet, lift the hips up, and you can slide the block to the side and slowly lower the hips all the way down. And then let's grab hold of our block and we're going to place the block underneath the shoulder blades. And then just lower the back body down so the back of the head is going to rest. We'll stay here for about 3 more breaths. And then we're going to lift all the way up. Just slide off of the block, let your body come all the way back down, and grab hold of the block and place it at the base of the skull, so like the bottom of the occipital ridge, and we'll just rock the head back from side to side. And then eventually, we're just going to lift all the way up off the block, slide it to the side. Let your body realign. And then come all the way up to seated, and we're going to leave the right leg exactly long and just bring the left knee in. So try to bring the left foot, left knee bent and back if it's comfortable for you. So it's like a little bit of a quad stretch. And then we're going to see how it feels to come down onto our back body again with that leg bent back. Take a few more rounds of breath. And then just come all the way up. And we'll switch it up to the opposite side. So you can lengthen your left leg long, draw your right foot in, and then maybe you start to come all the way down. See how that lands in your body. Stay there for just 3 more breaths. And then just slowly start to release that. If you want to come up and release it, go ahead, or just staying on your back, sliding your leg out. And we're going to land our left foot, cross the right ankle onto the left thigh. Just push the right palm into the right thigh and either stay like this or lift up, interlacing the palms. Stay there for about three more breaths. And then we're just going to release the left foot and release the right foot and then switch it the opposite way. Let's stay there for one more round of breath. And then we're just going to open our arms into cactus arms. So you can release the feet, open the arms into cactus, just drop them both over to the right. You can gaze over the left shoulder. And open up the right arm and just draw the knees through center. You can drop them the opposite way. Just bring the knees up, give the body one last little hug. And then finish out by stretching the legs out. Just coming into our final resting pose, our final shavasana. Whenever you're ready, we're just going to start to wiggle through our fingers and wiggle through our toes. Taking a nice long stretch through the whole body, fingers through toes. See if you can curl your knees into the chest, give the body a nice big hug. And then just slowly start to make your way up and over to your seated shape with your palms at your heart center. Closing our practice with an intention. And it's the ancient intention, but the original intention. Passed from heart to heart through thousands of years. And it's that our practice remain steady. Our efforts continuous. That our yoga helps and heals, and it serves and it benefits all beings everywhere. May all beings be safe. May they be happy. May they be healthy. May they be free. May the thoughts and the actions of each of our lives contribute towards this. And so let's just finish with an om sound, and we're going to breathe in, breathe out, breathe in, and make the om. So take a big breath in. Big breath out. Big breath in. Thank you so much for joining me, for sharing the space and the practice. Light in me, it sees.
And I light in you. Thank you, thank you.